Hey, what's up everyone? Welcome to this new episode of Swift Quiz. This time, I want to talk to you about the potentially confusing behavior of Swift that could very easily result in a weird bug in your app. So let's not waste any time and take a look at the code. You can see I've implemented a very simple struct called person. Inside this struct, there is one stored property called firstName, and you can see that on this property, I have defined a property observer. I've done it through the keyword didSet, and what this is going to do is that whenever the setter of the property is being called, this piece of code will also be executed. And now the question I want to ask is, do you think that when I initialize a new value of type person, the code inside the property observer dSet will be executed? On the one hand, it seems that the code inside this property observer should be executed, because after all, the entire purpose of a property observer is to be executed whenever a new value is set to a property. But on the other hand, we can also remark that here the property firstName is being set on a very particular context, because here the property is being set as part of the initialization of the value. As always, before I run the code and reveal the answer, let me know in the comments what your original thought was. Did you think that the code inside the property observer dSet would be executed or not? Alright, so before I run the code, let me bring the console up a little bit so that we can see what is happening. I'm going to click to run the code. So my code has just finished running. You can see the value of type person has indeed been successfully created, but you can also see that unfortunately the console is totally empty. And so this means that the code inside my property observer dSet was not executed, even though as part of initializing a new value of type person, I did set a value for the property firstName, which was the string Vincent. And this feels so weird that we might actually be tempted to think that maybe there is something wrong with this playground. So to test this theory, I'm going to bring the console down a little, and then I'm going to write a new line in my code. I'm going to set a new firstName on my value of type person. And this time I will set the firstName John. Okay, I need to bring the console up a bit so that we can actually see whether or not something will be printed this time. So I'm going to run the code once more. And this time we can see that the code inside the property observer was indeed executed, because a firstName was set has indeed been printed out to the console. So we can be reassured that indeed the playground is working just fine. However, we still need to come up with an explanation as to why in that second line the property observer was indeed executed, but it wasn't on this first line. First of all, you need to know that it's not a bug that the property observer was not executed when I initialized the value. It's actually on purpose that Swift doesn't call property observers when properties are given their first values as part of the initialization process. And this behavior comes from the fact that inside a property observer, we are absolutely allowed to use self. Of course, here with our struct person that actually implements only one property, it doesn't make a lot of sense to use self. But if I were to define a second property, for instance, last name on my struct, I could absolutely access that second property in the code of the property observer of my first property. And now it becomes easier to understand why Swift doesn't execute the property observer when the property is given its initial value. It's because here, if the property observer were to be executed when firstName is given its initial value, there would be no guarantee that at that time, lastName had also been given its initial value. If at that time lastName hadn't been given its first value, then executing the property observer would result in unsafe code, and that's something Swift absolutely wants to avoid. And actually, this behavior is not specific to property observers. If you ever tried to use self inside an init, you probably noticed that Swift won't let you use self until you have initialized all the stored properties of the value. Swift enforces this rule because, as we've just seen, using self before all stored properties of a value have been initialized can result in some potentially unsafe code. And so it's for that same reason that Swift won't execute a property observer when a property is given its initial value. So actually, I should have written a different print statement here. I shouldn't have written a first name was set, but rather a new first name was set, because the property observer will only be called to subsequent calls to the setter of the property first name. And while, as we've just seen, this behavior makes total sense, it is also an extremely confusing and surprising behavior. And that's why I wanted to make a video about it, because when you don't know about this behavior, it is very easy to rely on the idea that the property observer will also be called when the value is initialized, and thus potentially creating an also very surprising bug. That's all for this video. If you've enjoyed it, feel free to leave a thumbs up and subscribe. Thank you for watching, and see you next time.